Hi, okay, this is another quick video on the Ambika, just to show how to alter the volumes of the six filters that are inside the unit. This is one way to do it. It's very flexible. You can program different patches different ways. So let's have a look at quickly how we could alter volumes and things. So this is how it comes on. If I want to go straight to playing it, I've not got a keyboard attached, just one audio out and the power supply. Go to the performance page, and if I press this, that'll go through if there's a sequence in there. This is part 2 volume. This one's part 1 volume. There we go. So sequence has stopped. If I press here on custom, I can change what each of these 8 knobs does. So the first one changes the knob number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Next is which part it changes. Then we've got the parameter change. Now I happen to know that here, roughly there, where it says part volume, now assigned to knob one is part one volume. So then we can go to knob two, part two volume, knob 3, which is that one, part 3 volume, and we'll do the same for the rest of them. 5, 6 for part 6, part volume, knob 7. We can then assign that to any part, so I'll just put it to say part 1, and we'll do portamento, and knob 8 be the last. Go to part 2, tune, octave, well, we'll put it onto octave. There we go. So that's it done. So now I've got volume of part 1, volume, say part 2 volume, part 3 volume, 4 volume, 5 volume, part 6 volume, and then here I've got part 1 portamento, part 2 octave. So press play again. No volume. So now we'll turn part 1 up. Part 2 up. Now the others won't work. And this is because the voice cards have been used in a particular way. Just before we do this, I'm just going to go to here, to the octave. So I'm going to turn part 2 up. So I had to start and stop the sequencer there for it to recognise it. So I'll put that down to minus 1 octave. Start and stop the sequencer. Start it again, now it's down 1 octave. Down 1 octave, and I assume the reason it's not doing it straight away is because it's not set in the sequencer. So now we'll go to where it says voices here, which is switch number 6 voices and clock. So we're on part one, and part one is going to use three voice cards there, 1, 3, and 5. So if I deselect that one and deselect that one, now part one will just use voice card one. Go to part two, that was using 2, 4, and 6. So if I take that off, now part two is just using voice two, which means when I go to part three, I can use voice card three. Part four, can use voice card four. Part five, use voice card five. And part six, use voice card six. You can set your beats per minute. Your swing amount. And the clock amount. There we go. So that's now set up. So each voice card has an individual part, or each part has an individual voice card, whichever way you want to look at it. Let's go back to the performance page. Press here. There's voice one. That's voice two. Three. Part four. Part five, part six. So all those voices now have individual volume controls. You can see the six buttons lit up here. Yeah. So that shows you that all six are active. There's nothing in the sequencer that's playing anything because all the volume is down at zero. If I turn these up, that's all six voices now got volume. Yeah. This portamento doesn't work because there's no notes playing. I can stop that, start it again, and this one, part two, is now octave two. So let's go now to, there you go, stop the sequencer, put that on there. So all the other volumes are down, there's only part one volume that's on. So if we go to our voice, back to one, sorry, that one, so one, voice card one. So this is the voice we're going to be altering now. It has some notes here from C minus up to G9. You can alter that range across a keyboard. We're going to leave that as it is. I'm going to give it a sequence. So at the moment it's polyphonic mode. We're going to change that mode to mono. Legato allows it to play multiple notes at the same time. We don't want that at the moment. Portamento, you can alter on here, which is the slidey sort of nature. You can put the octave in, which will change to minus one. Tune it. We'll put a spread on there. This is the scale. Not scale, the temperament tuning. So we'll put it to equal. Second press brings us to the ARP or sequencer. Top button here, so we can have the step sequencer, the arpeggiator, or play a pattern. Yeah, so we'll try the step sequencer. The size of the grid, we'll go to 3/8. Length, we can take to wherever we want, second length and total length. There we go. Let's see if we can hear anything changed at all at the moment. So we'll go back to playing to start here. And no difference. let's have a look why. Just using this to skip through the values there. So we've got note C4, C4, C3, C3, C4, C4. There. And we've got a direction, a range, and a pattern. Now the pattern we can change. And we'll go to here. Still no pattern. Do we need to load in a pattern from the library? So that's a program. Multi patch sequence. Multi patch sequence. So let's see if we have a sequence. That one will do. So I don't know why that's not playing that. We'll try using arpeggio. Let's try the pattern. So it'll work the pattern but not the arpeggiator, probably because we don't have a keyboard plugged into the back. So let's go to sequence. And I just changed the grid there. Drop the sequence length. And the total length. That then alters. Range, does that do anything? Okay. Stop it and start it again. Try the portamento control. So there we have some portamento on it. Part one done, so part two. Part three. And part four. So if we go to part four now, into the sequencer and harp. Just check the sequencer, the step sequencer, arpeggio, and we went to pattern. Yeah, so we'll change that one to 30 seconds, put the length up a bit. And then we'll try that. So why is that? That part four, did I need to load a pattern in? Maybe I need to load a pattern in. So again, these are the notes, step sequence. So maybe I could change the note. And we'll see if that does anything. No, so go to volume. So part volume. More poly. Change more mono. Like I took off. Portamento, octave, tune spread. Change it to pattern. Okay. And go to there. Not so, I don't know why that's doing that. Anyway, let's try loading this because I don't know what I'm doing really. Right, so let's choose part one. Maybe it's because I haven't changed that to three. Pattern four. Maybe it's because I hadn't changed that. Pattern. One, 132 length. Maybe it was that. Direction down. Okay. And these C4 okay, so let's try that going to mode, change that to mono, go back to here. So now volume one, that doesn't work. That doesn't work. And that doesn't work. I don't know why. Interesting. Oh, because the sequence isn't running. Try pressing that. Now we've got the sequence. So I've got those two going. That one going. So let's see if we can change the. Let's try this one. So I need to go to. Voice, change part four to part five, and then come down here. I'll do voice on the four matrix tune voice beats per minute. That's where that is. So let's go here. Right. So this is where I change the sound of this voice, I assume. Okay, so I need to have something playing in the background. Now let's turn these right down and turn that one up. Now go to there and change. So that's a different sound. I can change between that sound and that sound. Add some noise. Add a sub-oscillator. change the to that cross modulation. Fuzz on it or not? Bit crush it. Have a play with the filter. Filter on the LFO. Got that sound in the background. We can also give it a sequence. Spread. Mono. That's turned off there, so I'll have to restart the sequence there. Go to sequence, mono, spread 3, and go to pattern. So then go to this sixth part. Go to voices, change that to 6. Go here. We could always set that to another parameter later on. filter, change it to a bandpass filter, put some resonance on. Something interesting going on in the voice. Three different LFOs. So we can use modulation 1 to 10, 14 sorry, not 10, modulation 1 source, so we can change that to L4-1, destination, modifier, change the leg slightly. Okay. And go on to we have it. Whether you're interested or not, it's the Ambika and it makes noises. Thanks again. See you later.